UN Women and UNODC have joined their forces to work to prevent trafficking and transnational crimes.
In the past, we've been working a lot on focusing on the illegal aspects of cross-border issues. The partnership with UN Women is allowing us to look more at communities, to look at those vulnerable communities that are being put under strain or who are under risk of falling prey to illicit activity or to terrorist activities.
UN Women has worked so far in 31 communities in Myanmar and Cambodia, awareness raising first to ensure that the women are aware of the risks and the threats of trafficking, legal support and sometimes some psychological support for survivors of trafficking. And also we are trying to provide some livelihood opportunities for women so that they are less at risk of trafficking. Women are given skills, waving, sewing or breeding catfish so they can sell them in the market.
UNODC is working with UN Women to strengthen the capacity of law enforcement officers to meet the needs of vulnerable communities. We are also going to be working with governments to make sure that women are included in the workforce, in police, in customs, in immigrations.
We want to prevent trafficking, but which community should we actually reach? In Cambodia, for instance, we are working in the border communities with women who are in the entertainment industries, and some of them are survivors of trafficking. Some of them are at risk of trafficking, but it's very important to engage with these women in particular. In Myanmar, we are working in Kachin State with women from IDP camps, or women in the host communities. They have lost their lands and their livelihood opportunities. And therefore, if we don't provide them any economic options, they might go into illegal routes.
One of the expected outcomes of this project is to have more women in law enforcement as well, making sure that the women who are part of those police stations or those border locations are given the space they need to become part of those law enforcement teams.
So I would like to thank the government of Japan on behalf of the women in Kachin State and on behalf of the women in Cambodian border communities. This program is extremely important and has made already changes in their lives.